Welcome to the Wonder Film. I'm Michael Van Patter, Director of Worship Arts at Hope Chapel. And on behalf of the entire organizing team, I want to say thanks for watching. In 16th century Germany, and then spreading to other parts of the world, a household item called a Wunderkammer became popular. That word translates to wonder chamber. They were also commonly called curiosity cabinets or wonder boxes. The idea was that you might have one of these medicine cabinet style boxes in your house, and it would be made with smaller compartments inside, which would be filled with interesting items. You might have rare or beautiful natural artifacts, like a unique stone or pine cone or small animal skull, or maybe exotic items collected while traveling. The concept was essentially to collect items that made the imagination come alive, to give an experience of wonder. Wonder being this beautiful combination of surprise and awe, amazement, joy, and curiosity. Okay, more on wonder boxes in a minute. This year has been so intense and heavy, and there seems to be an almost universal discouragement sort of hanging over us. As we thought about how to approach our Lessons and Carols service, the theme of wonder jumped out as a good word to our heavy hearts. The Bible's story of creation, rebellion, redemption, and restoration is filled with surprising twists, and perhaps none so surprising as the arrival of the long-awaited king in the form of a baby human being. Now, children have no trouble at all with the concept of wonder. We've all seen a child become totally mesmerized by something that an adult would not even have noticed, let alone stop to look at. And I think that's why Jesus pointed to children as a model for what it looks like to understand his kingdom. And so I want to invite you to watch this film with a child's wide eyes, to really take in the startling, beautiful story of God becoming human. What does that mean? Well, one thing that I believe is a friend to wonder is presence, really living in this moment before us, engaging with it and taking it all in. And so in these last moments before the film starts, I invite you to take a breath. Feel that air filling your lungs, perhaps light a candle, get something warm to drink, have a copy of the Wonder Guide, either the printed or digital one close by. Try to clear your mind for the next hour or so to be present with this wondrous story. You could think of this film as having 10 chapters. Each chapter will begin with a scene from our own Wunderkammer, our own wonder box. We created these scenes to stir our imaginations. Then there'll be a scripture reading guiding us through the narrative of the gospel. And finally, each chapter will include a song. And there might be a couple of fun surprises thrown in as well. So again, welcome. We're so glad you're here. Enjoy the Wonder Film.
There's a place, a garden for the young, to laugh nets and safety among shimmering light and shade of the tree. Steal a bite and paradise is lost. With darkened hearts, we didn't count the cost, forgot all we left behind. Life picks up speed before you know. Oh no, if it did life all along, we'd be proud to turn back now. One day it all falls down and breaks our heart and it breaks our crown, brings us down where we see. It's gonna be alright. Turn around and let back in the light. Enjoy. Like a bird in the morning sun. is a way that seems right to a man. Till he's in over head and he don't understand all the plans he made, only led him astray. Every good gift come down from above, from the Lord of light, like a labor of love on the child who waits for him. Sometimes you find what you're waiting for, it's all along just waiting for you. Turn around and reconcile. It may be broken down, all the bridges burn like an old ghost town. This my son can be.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be an expanse in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." And God made the expanse and separated the waters that were under the expanse from the waters that were above the expanse. And it was so. And God called the expanse heaven, and there was evening and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place. And let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas, and God saw that it was good. And God said, "Let the earth sprout vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees bearing fruit in which is their seed, each according to its kind on the earth." And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed according to their own kinds, and trees bearing fruit in which is their seed, each according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening and there was morning, the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the expanse of the heavens to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let them be lights in the expanse of the heavens to give light upon the earth." And it was so. And God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. And God set them in the expanse of the heavens to give light on the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good, and there was evening and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters swarm with swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the expanse of the heavens. So God created the great sea creatures and every living creature that moves, with which the waters swarm, according to their kinds, and every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. And God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the seas, and let birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures according to their kinds, livestock and creeping things and beasts of the earth according to their kinds. And it was so. And God made the beasts of the earth according to their kinds, and the livestock according to their kinds, and everything that creeps on the ground according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over the livestock, and over the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. And God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the heavens and over every living thing that moves on the earth. And God said, behold, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is on the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food, and to every beast of the earth and to every bird of the heavens and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life. I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day.
Back when they danced outside of time, before the stars would rule the night, there was a dove flew o'er the deep, deep water, and that's when they heard the voice of the lion start to speak. And there was life. When the light hits the water, the colors shine. Oh, but which one do you choose to paint the sky? Blue was the one that won. He shares it with the others in the evening at dawn. The rest of the colors are falling down. The water came together, and that's when they heard the voice of the lion name the ground. And I'm still dancing to the music from a garden that was so much brighter then, with the echoes of a long forgotten song escaping from my lungs within. And you can hear the movement through the overture that's playing if you listen to the end, because the dove and the composer will be dancing when the lion comes again. Cavernous empires of the sea, up through the clouds and on the green ground underneath. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa.
citizens rise with the dawn. And that's when they heard the voice of the lion name, the new sun, new sun. And I'm still dancing to the music from a garden that was so much brighter then, with the echoes of a long forgotten song escaping from my lungs within. And you can hear the movement through the overture that's playing if you listen to the end, because the dove and the composer will be dancing when the lion comes again. Who was the one that won, but shares it with the others in the end? Who was the one that won, but shares it with the others, shares it with the others? Who was the one that won, but he shares it with the others, shares it, oh. It began, oh, and I'll dance in the shadows until it comes again. Oh, and I'm still dancing to the music from a garden that was so much brighter than, with the echoes of a long forgotten song escaping from my lungs within. And you can hear the movement through the overture that's playing if you listen to the end, because the dove and the composer will be dancing when the lion comes again. Because the dove and the composer will be dancing when the lion comes again.
Now the serpent was more crafty than any other beast of the field that the Lord God made. He said to the woman, "Did God actually say, 'You shall not eat of any tree in the garden?'" And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden, but God said, 'You shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die.'" But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not surely die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be open, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were open, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves loincloths. And then they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman who you gave to be with me, she gave me the fruit of the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." Then the Lord God said, "Behold, the man has become like one of us in knowing good and evil. Now, lest he reach out of his hand and take also of the tree of life and eat, and live forever, Therefore, the Lord God sent him from the Garden of Eden to work the ground from which he was taken. He drove out the man, and at the east end of the Garden of Eden, he placed the cherubim and a flaming sword that turned every way to guard the way to the tree of life.
Can't relive my life, I can't retrace my tracks, I can't undo what's done, there is no turning back. I chased a selfish dream, did not survey the cost, illusions disappeared, I found my innocence lost. Some say it's lessons learned, some say it's living life, I say it's choices made, knowing wrong from right. One night I fought to sleep, in my slumber I turned and tossed, went to a cloudy child is a beautiful thing, secure in a father's arms, sleeps while mama sings. There's no way to know all the harm this world can bring. I miss my child is a beautiful thing, secure in a father's arms, sleeps while the mama sings. There's no way to know all the harm this world can bring. I miss my innocence, oh, to be innocent. Can't relive my life, I can't retrace my tracks, I can't undo what's done, there is no turning back. I chased a selfish dream, did not survey the cost, illusions disappeared, I found my innocence lost.
Thank you. And the Lord appeared to him by the oaks of Mamre, as he sat in the door of his tent in the heat of the day. He lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, three men were standing in front of him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them and bowed himself to the earth and said, O Lord, if I have found favor in your sight, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought, and wash your feet, and rest yourselves under the tree, while I bring a morsel of bread, that you may refresh yourselves, and after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant. So they said, Do as you have said. And Abraham went quickly into the tent to Sarah and said, Quick, three seahs of fine flour, knead it and make cakes. And Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to a young man who prepared it quickly. Then he took the curds and the milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them. And he stood by them under the tree while they ate. They said to him, Where is Sarah, your wife? And he said, She is in the tent. And the Lord said, I will surely return to you about the same time next year, and Sarah, your wife, shall have a son. And Sarah was listening at the tent door behind him. And Abraham and Sarah were old, advanced in years. The way of women had ceased to be with Sarah. So Sarah laughed to herself, saying, After I am worn out and my Lord is old, shall I have pleasure? The Lord said to Abraham, Why did Sarah laugh and say, Shall I indeed bear a son now that I am old? Is anything too hard for the Lord? At the appointed time, I will return to you about the same time next year, and Sarah shall have a son.
Born of guilt and separation, push your boat of hope from the shore. But like a lighthouse beacon, his heart is always seeking, and then it comes knocking at your door. And when he comes knocking at your door,
O Lord God of my salvation, I cry out day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my cry. For my soul is full of troubles and my life draws near to Sheol. I am counted among those who go down to the pit. I am one who has no strength. Like one set loose among the dead, like the slain that lie in the grave, like those whom you remember no more, for they are cut off from your hand. You have put me in the depths of the pit, in the regions dark and deep. Your wrath lies heavy upon me, and you overwhelm me with all your waves. You have caused my companions to shun me. You have made me a horror to them. I am shut in so that I cannot escape. My eye grows dim through sorrow. Every day I call upon you, O Lord. I spread out my hands to you. Do you work wonders for the dead? Do the departed rise up to praise you? Is your steadfast love declared in the grave, or your faithfulness in Abaddon? Are your wonders known in the darkness, or your righteousness in the land of forgetfulness?
Thank you.
There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, and a branch from his roots shall bear fruit. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide disputes by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt of his waist, and faithfulness the belt of his loins. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the lion and the fatted calf together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the cobra, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
The kingdom's coming as a seed, smaller than the eye can see. From wanting eyes to set us free, kingdom come. The kingdom's coming as a rain to wash away our castle's vain and cleanse a burden heart from stain. Kingdom come. The kingdom's coming as a word the wisest man has never heard, from foolish lips who speak the cure. Kingdom come. The kingdom's coming as a song, mournful dirge and anthem strong, to cheer the one who sing it wrong. Kingdom come. Ooh, ooh, a child will lead us say to all who open up the door. Kingdom come. The kingdom's coming to the poor, sons and daughters of the Lord, and all that's lost will be restored. Kingdom come. The kingdom's wine for all at least. We'll taste the broken bread of peace. Kingdom come. The kingdom's come and slow and true, till every inch has been made new, and it will ask your life of you. Ooh.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father, David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative, Elizabeth, in her old age has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For nothing is impossible with God."
Thank you. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Tore up the sky when you came down to us.
And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them into the heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds had told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart.
The sun.
At that time, the disciples came to Jesus, saying, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" And calling to him a child, he put him in the midst of them and said, "Truly I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven."
How fast can the cheetah run?
Cheetahs can run 60 miles per hour.
How big is the Earth?
Earth has an area of 196,939,900 square miles.
Tell me something amazing.
Let's see. You have so many good qualities that I don't know where to begin.
Can you swim across the whole world?
I'm afraid not.
Why is fire trucks red?
Well, it really makes the Dalmatian spot stand out.
Where does Santa live?
He's in your heart, and at the North Pole. Mostly at the North Pole.
Hey Siri, how long can...
Dad, what are you doing?
Just listening. What are you doing?
Asking Siri questions. Watch. Hey Siri, how tall is a T-Rex?
The answer I found is 12 feet.
You asked some big questions, bud.
Ooh!
Hey Siri, how many bugs are in the world?
There's an estimated 10 quintillion insects on the globe.
Dad, you try one.
I don't know what to ask.
Don't you ask me questions too?
Not really.
Why not?
I don't know. I used to.
When did you stop?
Hey Siri, what am I getting for Christmas?
I'm not sure I understand.
Okay, bud. Make sure you clean up the mess before dinner. After you finish playing.
Okay, Dad.
Hey Siri, what's the largest galaxy in the universe?
The largest galaxy by average radius is NGC 5033. The average radius.
Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore, for the former things have passed away." And he who is seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making."